Hey, what's up? This is Sifu Cuddle. For this vlog, I want to tell you about this exciting project that I worked on. It's about to come out this October. I was able to work with Art School Dropouts. If you haven't seen anything from Art School Dropouts, definitely check them out. They are a super cool group. They do action, comedy, even drama, and they have some amazing fight scenes and some amazing choreography. I was actually flown out to New Jersey for a week to work with these guys, and we filmed a handful of fight scenes. We filmed a handful of videos, some random ones, some acting ones, a cool cowboy kung fu fight scene where I die like three times. And then we even filmed a couple other fight scenes that'll be coming out soon. You can actually see them. But one of the biggest things was we filmed something that the head of the group, Joey, has been kind of, he's had in the works for probably 5+ years now, and that's this web series called The Forgotten Kingdom, a Kung Fu LARP story. If you know anything about LARP, it's probably from internet memes or the movie Role Models, and it doesn't have the best rep. Especially online. LARPing stands for live action role playing. It's kind of like Dungeons and Dragons, except for they can do it in real life. They'll actually make these foam weapons and make their armor and everything, and they go out and they'll battle each other on a huge battlefield. And it's pretty cool, actually. If you get a chance to look into some of the really like serious groups, they have some amazing stuff that they do. Even the weapons that we had for the series were actually really well made. We got them from Epic Armory. They have tons of foam weapons, armor, and all sorts of things, and they're made to withstand hits and combat, and it's actually a lot of fun. The premise of Forgotten Kingdom, a Kung Fu LARP story, is mixing martial arts and LARPing. So what if all these LARPers were really skilled with their weapons, like Kung Fu level skilled? That's where Art School Dropouts takes this. You get some comedy in there, you get some good storyline, and you get some amazing fighting with some amazing people. They also brought in a lot of people, especially from the industry. If we're talking stunts and being in movies, I mean, number one, you're gonna see Vincent Lin. Like, that is amazing to me. And if you don't know the name, you'd recognize him from Jackie Chan's stunt team. He was in quite a few Jackie Chan movies. So he was in it. He's actually in the first episode, if I recall. And it's super cool to see him in it. They also brought out a professional stuntman from Canada, DL McDonald. Not only is DL a professional stuntman, but he also has experience. He was working for medieval times, so he's probably the most experienced working with medieval weapons and armor and all of that, and acting as the king. So this guy does an amazing job in the role. We also had some fun filming some other videos that he actually wrote some dialogue for. It was a blast to work with DL, like total professional and a really good mentor for me when working on my stunts. I'm not gonna lie, this was like a week-long boot camp for stunts. It's something I've never done before. Like, we've done some fight scenes here and there, but never on this level, especially with people so experienced. I had a lot to learn. DL definitely gave me a lot of advice and helped me out working things out. That was really cool. Let me tell you, I've known Joey since the MySpace days. Back in 2000, I think I first met him. We were in a Kung Fu group on MySpace, and people would post videos and, you know, post commentary or pictures. He would post a video and, oh, that's so cool, you know, and then I would post a video and he would be, you know, really supportive of it. It just kind of went from there. Over time, you know, we never lost contact and we were always kind of following each other as we progressed further into social media and, of course, YouTube and kind of where our paths went. So it was really cool for me to have a chance to go out and work with him, especially after, you know, seeing his videos and, you know, his Art School Dropouts, all that work that he's been putting into that. It was really a treat and really special to actually go out and meet a friend of mine that I've known for so many years, but actually work with them in the field that they excel at, and something that I can jump right in and feel like, you know, I can contribute to it. And then there's Stephanie. You see her, she's a part of the crew, she's always in fight scenes, she's an actress, she's a model, she's actually behind the camera a lot of the time as well. And you don't really see from YouTube, but she works a lot behind the scenes. She's got everybody on schedule, she's doing casting calls, she's doing all of the background stuff for Art School Dropouts, and it's super impressive to see how she can keep all of that together and keep people on schedule. And be a part of the filming and be in front of the camera at the same time and always be positive. That's the thing that I was truly impressed by. So there's also intern or Angela. When I actually first flew out there, she was competing at a tournament. So she was gone the first couple of days. She was also being interviewed out there. She's actually made quite a name for herself through art school dropouts as well. When she came back, she was definitely there keeping together, picking up all the loose ends, working a lot in the background as well, just making sure that everything was coming together. For me, it was a real treat to see not only how people contribute to the group, but what they do behind the scenes. Now, Joey, he is an amazing choreographer and an amazing martial artist and a truly humble guy. Like, through my friendship of knowing him for so long, I didn't realize how cool of a person he could be. Finally getting to work with him in person really proved to me that no matter how skilled you are, you can still be humble and you can still be grateful to work with people. And that was a really cool feeling for me. The heart that he puts into everything that he does. I mean, this guy not only choreographs, directs, you know, he's running the camera, he's got the vision, he's writing all the scripts. He makes sure that you feel important as part of this, and he makes sure that you don't feel left out or pushed around or anything. It's really amazing to work with him. And the choreography is just insane. Just watching him put things together, you know, he'll be talking and all of a sudden he kind of goes into a choreographer mode, you know, he kind of works things out, takes out his iPad, you know, takes notes down, sets everything up. And the way that he can visualize these fight scenes is just incredible. To me, one of the most impressive things was watching him edit. Now, we were literally shooting and then we would go back and he would edit and have it done, you know, 98% ready to go, like ready to view within an hour, hour and a half. Like, the guy was amazing at editing. For what I do, I don't have to work too hard at editing. I just have to do a little bit of color correction here and there. Watching him work just blew me away. And I learned a lot about editing from him, especially now that I'm working in Premiere. That guy is like a magician in Premiere. He was making things happen. It was crazy. It was awesome. That's a lot I have to say about that group. And we even brought some people down. Like, I met some people from Common Ramen. Those guys were awesome to work with. It's cool because there's people that I've seen online. I've seen people on Facebook. I've seen people on Instagram. I've seen people on YouTube. But then to go to work with them in person and actually have them recognize me. Like, I know I have a following. I just didn't realize, you know, how far that went out. So it's kind of neat to see when we all kind of come together and how tight-knit the community is too. That was really cool for me. I thought the martial arts world was small between the conversations that DL and Joey were having, like, oh, did you see this guy's stuff? Oh yeah, do you remember when he did this and how about that? And just realizing that everybody knows everybody, and that's really cool. For me, my heart is always in teaching. If there's a contribution that I can have into that world, I just, you know, hope that I have a good representation. So again, The Forgotten Kingdom, A Kung Fu LARP Story is coming out soon. They are raising funds for it, so apparently they had a financial backer and everything was set. They started buying tickets to fly me out, to fly DL out. They were buying props. And then last minute, the financial backer just backed out. So they had to fund everything themselves, and it's such a cool project. If you can, check out their Indiegogo page. I will leave a link in the description below, and you guys can check it out and contribute to it. Any contribution is super helpful. For me personally, I've got their backs. Like, they are an amazing group. Definitely keep an eye out for them. Even if you don't contribute, be sure to share. Try to get the word out, because there will be people that will help out. And it was one of the best projects, I have to say. Like, one of the most memorable projects I've ever worked on. And that's super exciting. So definitely check them out. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe. And check out some of my other videos too. I do have Patreon coming out, and that's gonna have some videos for things that have always been requested, but I've never actually put out online. So keep an eye out for that, and I'll see you guys next time. Till then, this is Sifu Cuddle.
Bam! Fizz with a bow out.